Hello all, I'm Meher Taj Hej from Indian Institute of Technology, Madras, India. And I'm here to present for the conference, AAAFM UCLA 2021, on the topic, the modeling of magnetological gels, a size effect study. So, the topic I'm presenting on now is the modeling of magnetological gels, a study on the particle size effect. So the outline of my presentation, I'm just will be starting off with the introduction, followed by the mathematical preliminaries involved in development of the model, followed by the model development statement and the total stress derivation, surface energy concepts involved in the development of the model, with the validation of the model, followed by the size effect study with the conclusions at the end of the presentation. Magnetological materials are a group of smart materials that are composed of the magnetic particles, either in a polymer matrix or on a carrier fluid, whose properties can be altered upon the application of the magnetic field, just as the picture which I have shown over here. The applications that depends upon the basic idea of the magnetological materials are engine mounts, isolated for the building structures, adaptive tuned vibration isolators, and vehicle transmission systems. So, in general, various experimental works have been already, there has been a vast extensive research on the experimental works on the magnetorheological materials to see how the properties of the materials vary under the influence of the magnetic field. To support the experimental part, a wide research area that is being worked on is the constitutive frameworks to, developed on the magnetorheological materials. Very few works concentrated on developing the constitutive frameworks for the MR gels, but they did not account for the time-dependent behavior of the magnetorheological gels. For these different magnetic materials, model has been developed to realize this time-dependent behavior. But the continuum-based models have a limitation to in their capacity that cannot predict the dependence of the microstructural dependent arrangement of the particles. Micromechanical-based frameworks gain more attention since they incorporate the micromechanical details of the magnetic particles, that how they are placed within the matrix. In the mid-90s, Jolly et al. Developed a 1D lattice model to study the phenomena that involved in the magnetorheological gels. Followed by this, Ivanko and his co-workers did an extensive research on the lattice model and successfully predicted the behavior of the MR gels under the magnetic field applied. The gap which we find over here is, though the lattice model possesses many valuable features, it does not capture the viscoelastic behavior. Also, the study on the particle size effect on the performance of the MR gels and the constitutive model to support the to predict the size effect of the properties of the MR gels are very, very less. So, in this present work, we will be starting off with the macrostructural based model will be developed to study the particle size effect, and the surface interaction between the matrix and the particles will be introduced. A time-dependent viscoelastic model, which has already been developed, will be used as a base model. The combined framework will be calibrated and validated using a set of experimental data. This calibrated model will be further used to analyze the particle size effect on the behavior of the MR gels. So the present work will be starting off with the mathematical preliminaries, which involves the kinematics of the magnetorheological gels. Generally, the deformation of the body can be easily tracked down by specifying a point in a magnetic material configuration, and will be relocated to the spatial configuration, and this one can be mapped easily using a deformation map curve. The deformation gradient F can be obtained through this deformation map curve and is defined in equation 1. Based upon this deformation gradient, the left and right Cauchy-Gridens tensors can be given using the equation 2. In general, the deformation gradient will be decomposed into elastic and the viscous contributions in order to model the time-dependent response of the polymeric materials. Also, since we are dealing with the magnetorheological materials, the magnetomechanics concept also plays a vital role in the development of the model. The fundamental variables in the magnetomechanics are magnetic field, magnetization, magnetic induction. And the relationship between the these parameters between the material and the spatial configuration are defined in equation 4. Followed by the kinematics, the balance laws has to be established for the development of the model. The balance laws relevant to the magnetomechanics are defined in equation 5, which are the result of the Maxwell equations. And the equation 5 will be satisfied only when the equation 6 possesses well. The connection between the three parameters, magnetic field, magnetization and the magnetization and magnetic induction are shown in the equation 7. The total first Pierre-Louis Kirchhoff stress tensor P dot are related using the second Pierre-Louis Kirchhoff stress and total Cauchy stress, which are given in the equation 8. On the whole, the total Pierre-Louis stress is given by, or we can consider it is conceived as the sum of the mechanical component, magnetic component and the Maxwell component. The constitutive equations which are involved in the development of the model are: the strain energy functions of the material can be generally described as a function of the deformation gradient, internal variable and the magnetic variable, and is applicable for all isothermal case, and it is dependent on the three independent parameters. The total energy is expressed as shown in equation 10, with N0 being the free field magnetic energy. For an isothermal case, the Clausius-Duhem inequality can be expressed as del naught, and which is expanded and expressed as shown in equation 12. Using these, the constitutive relations are defined in the terms of the total energy as shown in equation 30. So, we'll be starting off with the model. In general, MR gel consists of magnetic particles embedded in a polymer matrix. The particles, upon application of the magnetic field, respond. In here, the stiffness of the gel is highly influenced by the magnetic particles, since the particles are much more stiffer than the matrix. Various works have shown the enhancement or the improvement in the modulus in both isotropic and anisotropic gels upon the application of the magnetic field. The strain energy per unit volume of the gel composed of the magnetic and mechanical, and the term which we are introducing over here is the interfacial interactions that have that occur between the matrix and the particles. First, I'll discuss with the magnetic and the mechanical contributions. Later, I'll discuss the interfacial interactions. So, the strain energy can be described as sum of the magnetic contribution and mechanical contribution. So, mechanical contribution is further decomposed into two, which will be realized as a sum of the purely elastic one and viscoelastic component. So, the magnetic strain energy, the strain energy functions which will start off deriving, the magnetic strain energy per unit volume is described as shown in the equation 16, where mu naught and mu r are the relative permeability of the vacuum in the medium respectively, but mu naught being the volume of the total volume of the MR gel sample. The MI and MG term are the dipole moments, and where small vb denotes the volume of the particle. Here, RIG denotes the vectorial distance in the spatial configuration between the ith and the jth particle. Using these information, equation 16 is rewritten as equation 17. Further, bringing in various information like RA being the distance, capital RA being the distance between the particles in the material configuration, it is rewritten to bring in the relationship of the distance between the particles in the spatial and the material configuration as small ri is equal to fri. The reduced magnetization term is used to simplify the term equation 17. So m bar is used is the ratio of magnetization and the saturation magnetization. Using these identities, equation 17 is further reduced, and where the beta denotes the number of particles per chosen representative lattice, while n represents the total number of particles within the gel sample. Now, the magnetic part is done. We'll move on with the mechanical part. The elastic and viscous contribution of the MR gel associates with the volume fraction. So, the volume fraction of the magnetic particle is considered to be 5. So, the rest of the part contributes to be 1 minus 5. Using Aradaboy's formulated 8-chain approach, the elastic and viscous contributions, which is also a microstructural based one, the strain energy functions are defined using the Aradaboy's 8-chain approach, as shown in equation 19 and 20. So, in the equation 19 and 20, G and GV represent the shear modulus of the elastic and viscous response of the MR gel sample. And NE and NV represent the number of Kunz segments per polymer chain of the elastic and viscous network. Upon phi summation terms have been used. And since the influence of the particles are higher, I1 has been altered to I1H, which is written as Y of I1 minus 3 plus 3, where I1 is the trace of the left Cauchy green tensor, followed by the mechanical part. The total stress derivation using the magnetic and mechanical part will be defined over here. Using the above mentioned equations, the total stress is given by the summation of the terms shown in 21 equation. So, in equation, it is composed of the elastic part, mechanical part, and the magnetic part. In addition to the components, the surface energy concepts will also be included. Which I will discuss in the later part. The surface stress that accounts for the surface interaction between the magnet matrix and the particles will be introduced. The stresses that are pertaining to the elastic and viscous parts of the mechanical component using the 8-chain model as described above previously are shown in equation 22 and 23. Similarly, the magnetic part of the total stress obtained using the equation 18 is expressed as follows in equation 24. So now we'll go into the surface energy concepts. The stress that arises due to the interaction between the magnetic particles and the polymer matrix is denoted by the P sub. Generally, the surface area and the mass of the spherical particle whose diameter is d is denoted by SD and MD and is given as shown in equation 25. And the single particle surface energy is expressed easily in equation 26. Where gamma denotes the interfacial tension. The surface energy per unit volume is rewritten for n number of particles as shown in equation 28. Further, using the above equation, the stress due to the surface interaction between the particles and the matrix is deduced and is given by equation 29. This 29th equation will be summed up and the total stress will be rewritten as equation 38. Now, the expression related to the stresses will be of elastic stress, magnetic stress, viscous component, and the surface stress. All these will be derived, and when put together, the total stress can be computed using the equation 30, which will be further implemented in the study of the size effect and how it affects the properties of the MR gels. This model is validated by validating it with a set of data which obtained from the previous work. This experimental data is conducted by performing the shear test and isotropic MR gels using a free decay test apparatus and a different magnetic field values to obtain its properties. And isotropic gels are made up of carbon aligned particles with an average shape of size of 3.2 micrometer. The interfacial tension between the value of the interfacial tension of the MR gel sample is found out to be 203.55 millijoules per meter square. Further, the parameters are calibrated and tabulated in Table 1. The comparison between the experimental data and the model is shown in Figure 2, where we can see that there is quite a good agreement between the model and the experimental data. The size effect study. Here, to study the size effect of the imaginary particles and the properties of the emergence, three different sizes are considered: 1.4 micrometer, 3.4 micrometer, and 6 micrometer. To start off with the size study, the Frohlich-Kinele equation that defines the relationship between the magnetization and the magnetic field strength of the magnetic particles are given below, which is shown in equation 31, which is reduced using the form M dash and is given as shown in equation 32, which when plotted, when the graph is plotted between the M bar, that is reduced magnetization, and the reduced magnetic field, the plot is shown in the plot we can obtain is as shown in figure 3. The saturation magnetization values of these magnetic particles, that as I mentioned before, that are three different sizes of the carbon ion particles, 1.4 micrometer, 3.4 and 6, are 203.5 kiloamps per meter, 100.4 kiloamps per meter, and 46.5 kiloamps per meter. And similarly, the initial permeability values are obtained from a previous work. For the given strain values, using the above found values in equation 30, the total stress is computed for these three sizes of the particles at various reduced magnetic field strengths, say 0.5, 1 and 5. And the results are shown in figure 4, where we can clearly see that as the size decreases, the shear stress value increases. That as the magnetic field value increases, that say when we compare between the magnetic reduced magnetic field strength value of 0.5 and 5, there is a huge difference between them. This, it shows that the modulus value also increases as the particle size decreases. This increase in the modulus can be related to the fact that the lower sized particles possess a very high surface area to volume ratio than the greater sized particles, which further raises the interaction energy between the particles and enhances the properties of the gels. These results are compatible with the earlier stated works. This effectiveness of the model is verified by comparing it with the data obtained from my previous work. The samples are prepared in the absence of the magnetic field and are made up of CI particles of two different sizes, such as 1.4 and 3.4 micrometer. The sample comprises of 5% of filler materials with solvent and the copolymer ratio of 4:1. From the figure 5, where we can see that the equation 30 provides a relatable agreement between the experimental and the numerical simulation. So the conclusions which we obtained from the work is that the microstructural based model that captures the time dependent viscoelastic behavior has been adopted. This adopted model is extended to account for the surface interactions between the matrix and the magnetic particles to study the particle size effect on the properties of the emergers. This developed model is calibrated and validated using a previously developed, found out set of experimental data. Further, the size effect on the attributes of gel is studied, and the results reveal that as the particle decreases, the shear stress value increases for the given shear strain values. This behavior is constantly observed for all the three reduced magnetic field strengths. So here are the references which I have used to develop this work. Thank you. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to present my smallest work in a greatest conference that is happening. Thank you.